Hey, I've been wanting to reach out to you for a little while now, but now that I have some free time, I can finally sit down and write out to you. I used to have a friend who passed away about 7 years ago from a really bad car accident, hit a semi-truck. God rest his soul. This man used to do all sorts of water sports, diving, fishing. The man lived in the water. He was kind of a freak, but I mean that in the best and loving way. I grew up close with him, so he was like a brother to me. The man loved to fish and even was training to do Olympic-style swimming. If my memory serves me correctly, he had even done some stints back in the 90s and early 2000s to where he swam 50-plus miles or something like that. I could be wrong on that, but it was something crazy, I do know that. Well, he was also known to my family and circle of friends for his diving that he would do. He was a huge fan of looking for wrecks and things like that. Old wreckage just really excited him. He had gone diving off the coast of California, New York, Maine, Florida, Texas, you name it, and even spent quite a bit of time in the Gulf. Since I'm not a diver, I don't know what goes into it professionally, the skills you need or the equipment. But from being good friends with him and being very close, I know he was very good at it. When we would catch up on the phone and have talks, he would go on and tell me about some of the amazing diving adventures that he would have had and some amazing things that he would discover. Now, I've been a watcher of your channel for over a year now, and I see that just very recently, you started covering a topic about deep sea related things, and I thought, what a perfect opportunity for me to share with you his stories. The first story I'm going to share with you was back in 2010 when he was wreck diving in Lake Superior, north of Wisconsin, but closer to the eastern border of North Dakota. He had gone diving with two other close individuals, one of whom was seriously hospitalized during this incident. Luckily, him and his other friend remained unscathed. The story goes that they dove down there looking for wreckage of any kind, and they thought they had spotted some. But that's when one of the friends discovered what appeared to be a large, transparent, blob-like figure floating in the water. This blob-like figure was around 8 to 9 feet tall, and probably about 12 feet in width, from what he told me. A giant, massive bulb of a blob. It was opaque and off-white in color. It didn't really move like a jellyfish or a jellyfish-like being, like you would probably think. He explained it was kind of floating in the water. Well, the one friend who swam close to it to observe it better, at a closer distance, started experiencing severe third-degree burns all over his body, minus the backside, just the front side to where he became exposed to this. He swam close, and he began screaming and had to ascend back up to the boat, where my friend and his friends followed after him. Going back up to the boat, all three of them, he took off his wetsuit and discovered his skin on the front of his torso, face and arms were literally boiling and nearly falling off. He had to be life flighted to a hospital to where he experienced severe skin grafts. I wasn't told every single detail, but that's what he explained to me. He also got severe nitrogen poisoning because he ascended so quickly. That story alone freaked me out, and I asked him what he thinks it was. They were probably about 70 feet down, and as you know, there's not a whole lot of light. So, they were using the lights that they had with them, and as it got close, the friend of course started immediately experiencing this sort of pain sensation. After the person got out of the hospital, he said it was like a severe chemical burn, and not like a fire burn. It was the strong searing pain all over his flesh. He did not receive burns on his backside, only his skin that was closest to this blob. He got probably within 20 feet of it, and from what my friend who passed away told me. It's safe to say that their wreckage diving was cut short that day. They never did tell anybody what exactly happened, or what they saw, out of fear that they'd be accused of attempted murder. Again, nobody has any idea what it was, or what it could have been. I speculated with him that it could have been some sort of jellyfish or man-o-war. But he's gone diving in the ocean so many times, he knows what both of those creatures look like very well. This looked nothing like neither of them, and there were no visible tentacles anywhere near this blob figure. There was no indication from the water temperature that it emitted light or any sort of heat. My friend, the one who passed away, came to the ultimate conclusion, which is just a wild guess, but the best guess in my opinion, was that it was indeed giving off severe amounts of radiation. It's the only explanation that he can come up with that would actually answer it, but it doesn't fully make 100% sense. It's still just a mystery. Another time, he was also wreck diving off the coast of Maine with a larger crew of people. I don't recall how many miles he was off the coast, but I know it was somewhat significant. I think they actually had a particular wreck they were looking for, but I might be wrong on that. He mentioned to me that somewhere down near the bottom, as they were scouting, an amphibious type of hand, many times larger than his own, reached out from underneath the sand and silt and grabbed onto his wetsuit, nearly tearing it open with so much force. The creature swam out of the silt and away from him. He described it as very mermaid-looking, but not in a fantasy or traditional sense that we all think. He described it as a more humanoid half-man half-fish sense. Described the face as very humanoid-looking, with large black eyes and large scaly hands with webbing in between the fingers. It had a strange purple oozing bruise on his leg, and it gripped him so hard. When they had gotten out of the water, he had this weird plasma-like goop all over his leg where it grabbed him. It freaked out all the other divers because it was so sudden and out of nowhere. After it grabbed onto him, it pulled itself out of the silt and swam away in the opposite direction. He said it was a very large creature and estimated it to be between 13 and 16 feet in length, and described the upper body being very humanoid-looking, but also very amphibious. The bottom half was just like an elongated fish body with a long tail. This is why and where he used the term mermaid. Yet another dive ended prematurely. Even with these strange events, these things have not stopped him from going out practically living in the water. This man has also been face to face with barracuda, sharks, and a bunch of other extremely dangerous situations underneath the water. There's even one time where he accelerated too quickly, just like his other friend, and nearly died of nitrogen poisoning back when he was just a rookie diver. Yet, he's taken out by a semi-truck in the winter. It was a tragedy. We all figured he would have gone out either drowning or being eaten alive, but that's not what his final chapter looked like. The fact of the matter is, no matter what situation he found himself in, life-threatening or not, he still pursued the thrill of the deep water. I think wreck scavenging was probably his number one pastime, among other things. Of course, he too also had stories, because he had some close friends who were in the Navy and other parts of the military that had some kind of classified information from what I was explained to. One of my favorite stories of his that he tells me is that his one longtime Navy friend, who he concealed the identity of because he didn't want any information to be revealed about this particular individual. This individual was sailing in the South Pacific back in the early 80s on a smaller military boat when an extremely large object appeared on the radar machinery. At first glance, they all thought it should be an opposing submarine, but realized it was actually a biolife form. Whatever it was estimated to be anywhere between 90 feet to 150 feet in length, and was also several miles down under the water. Or, there's another similar situation where back in the late 70s, they had an entire submarine and crew perish due to being attacked by some unknown large creature. Whatever it was had to have been large enough to take down a military-tier submarine in the Pacific Ocean. Over 80 crew and 11 officers all perished with the submarine. The assailant of the submarine was never made known, but it was documented that there was indeed a struggle, and the submarine fired off all of its missiles against the unknown assailant, but made no luck. This was, from what I've been told, about 200 miles southwest off the coast of Alaska. I've also heard stories from several places where military personnel have talked about finding washed up, half-eaten whale carcasses with humongous bites taken out of them. These whale carcasses were partially devoured or halfway devoured. These have been usually found in the areas that military personnel were deployed close by. The one that comes to my mind is a story where an individual, a different one, a sergeant, whose name I will not mention, encountered three of these dead whales at once that had washed up right near an undisclosed military base. All three of them showed the same signs of being partially eaten, devoured by the same large predator. This predator had taken out chunks of meat so large and massive in its bite that the bite marks dwarfed that of a great white shark in comparison. It's stories like that that will keep me out of the ocean. These kinds of sightings were actually far more common than you can imagine. The military has all sorts of reports on large water amphibians and reptilians that are classified, apparently. For example, if you Google this, there is a case back in 1914, I believe, I might be unsure of the year, of a large military ship seeing a large water crocodile that was estimated to be around 60 feet in length. I can't remember where, and I want to say it was off the Europe coast, but you can find out. This information was kept from the public for quite some time, but all it takes is for you to know somebody who knows somebody. Unfortunately, once my friend passed, all of his connections who knew stuff and had stories were severed with his death. He had good friends in many places, but fortunately, he was able to tell me a lot of them before he died. He and I would just sit down and spend hours talking over the phone, or if we were in person, have a few beers and just talk and talk, and he would tell me story after story. Not always creature stuff, but situations he was in where he almost died, or incredible diving stories. I just thought you would find these two particular cases I shared with you interesting, since it fit right up your alley.